what you like about yourself, what you dislike about yourself. While answering such questions, we disclose some facts and some thoughts we keep within ourselves. Now, how do we determine the strengths and weaknesses we have, or the good and the imperfect features we possess? Where did those beliefs come from? A judgmental teacher, a circle of friends, parents, siblings, relatives, caretaker who label you a certain way, or maybe from yourself. Each person has a self-image, the mental blueprint that describes the kind of person they are. This very important self-conception holds the beliefs we have about ourselves. Some are positive and some are detrimental to moving forward and making changes. And it's not about success or failure always. It's about how we feel about ourselves. I didn't like my nose. I was really nosy about this nose. I can remember the chain of events that resulted in this dislike. But I did not like my nose. Though never did I have any problem related to breathing or smelling. I mean, that's what a nose is expected to do. When I was expecting my first child, my main concern was the baby should not inherit my nose. Again, I don't know when I found out that our noses were similar, because it never mattered. She filled me up with enormous joy and will always be the most beautiful person I've ever seen. And today, since our noses are similar, I'm in love with my nose. And I would love to have this nose of mine in my coming words. So you see, it's all in the mind. Whenever I hear the word mind, I remember the phrase, mind is a monkey. There was an experiment carried out to analyze the pattern of behavioral conditioning in a group. In a zoo, there were 5 monkeys in a cage. One day, a banana was hung from the ceiling and a ladder kept underneath it so that the banana could be reached by climbing up the ladder. Seeing this, one of the monkeys started climbing up the ladder. And just when it was about to take the banana, all of the monkeys were sprayed with cold water by the zoo attendants with a hose. Naturally, the monkey up the ladder came running together and all of them were howling and growling. They tried after some time, but the same water spraying happened. So, after some time, after various attempts, they stopped themselves from trying to get the banana. The next day, the banana was replaced, but none of them even looked at it, knowing very well the aftermath of trying to get the banana. After some days, one of the monkeys was replaced with a new one. The new one was astonished as to why none of the other monkeys had tried to get the banana. And he started climbing the ladder. The minute he did so, all the other monkeys came running together and met the hell out of this new monkey. He was shocked and could not understand what he did to receive the beating. He didn't know the past and was ignorant of the fact that they were anticipating same cold water spray. He tried a couple of times more. Eventually, he stopped because he received the same result every time. Again, after a few days, one of the old monkeys was replaced by a new one. So now, there were 3 old monkeys and 2 new ones. The new one was tempted to get the banana. Well, he was beaten up badly. But the surprising thing was that the monkey who came earlier also took part in the beating, without even knowing why the beating was taking place. Could be so, since he was being beaten, this was his way to get even. Slowly, all the monkeys were replaced with new ones. And none of the new monkeys were ever sprayed with cold water. But you know what? None of them even tried to get the banana. And even if anyone tried, he was bitten up by the rest. Interesting, right?
Yes.
Now look closer, around you. And you'll see that we all do similar stuff every day. Doing things just because someone asked us to do, or someone else is doing so, without even questioning the logic or the reason. This is conditioning. And we all are products of the conditioning that we receive. I studied in a convent school. And right from the beginning, we were told to talk softly. And you know what happened? A month back, I gave my icebreaker speech. And I was not audible to all. I can be loud. My husband can vouch for that. I felt so bad. that I decided the next morning that even if any Toastmaster get deafened, I will shout my heart out. So our successes and failures are not the results of what we do, rather the conclusions that we draw from them. It's for us to decide whether we'll keep monkeying around or free ourselves from the cage of conditioning. To do so, we only need to harness the power of rational thinking. As I said earlier, our negative beliefs are the conclusions we draw. Rational thinking, which is rational and logical, can be used to control the unconscious mind. To start uprooting the beliefs that create your sense of inferiority, ask why. Doing so will help you analyze and free yourself from the false assumptions that I failed yesterday, so I'll fail today. Instead, when faced with rational thinking, you realize that each day presents an opportunity to learn, and you learn from the mistakes you made. Our success and failure are the result of forces buried deep within our heart, within our personality. So take out your editing pen. It's time to make some changes and lead a co-pacific life. Thank you.